So in this session, we are going to talk about different Ctrl+M ports used whenever different components of Ctrl+M interact with each other. So one thing is we have learned that Ctrl+M EM client interacts with Ctrl+M EM. So on Ctrl+M EM side, there is a service running which is called Ctrl+M EM core bus server. Okay, this is the service which enables Ctrl+M EM client to interact with Ctrl+M EM. Okay, so you need to make sure that port 13075 is open between the system where you have Ctrl+M EM client installed and the system where you have Ctrl+M EM running. Okay, if the port is not opened, you are going to get errors with respect to that Ctrl+M EM is not available or something like that. Now usually Ctrl+M EM client is installed on a laptop or jump host servers, so you need to just make sure that there is an active connection between that system to Ctrl+M EM system. Now in order to see whether the port is opened or not, you can run telnet command. So the way telnet works is that you need to run this telnet command from a source system. So let's say if you want to see whether the port from this system is opened and working to Ctrl+M EM system, so you need to run this telnet command on the source system. Okay, so you are going to run this telnet command here on this system, and here you are going to type telnet and then space and then IP address of Ctrl+M EM system. Okay, so whatever the IP address is of this Ctrl+M EM system, that's the one which you need to type, and then you need to provide the port. Okay, by default Ctrl+M EM core bus services runs on port 13075, so if you have not made any changes, you can test this port. Again, one important thing is you may get error that telnet is not available. Okay, in that case you need to make sure first that you have telnet utility installed on this system from where you are testing. Okay, now let's move on. So how Ctrl+M EM interacts to Ctrl+M server? So Ctrl+M EM and Ctrl+M server interacts with each other using EM gateway services. Okay, so EM gateway service interacts on port 2370 and 2371. Okay, so this Ctrl+M server, listens on a port which is called 2370. So whenever Ctrl+M EM communicates with Ctrl+M server, that is going to happen on 2370, and then Ctrl+M server is going to open another service which are going to be listening on port 2371. Okay, so basically you should have both of these ports open between Ctrl+M EM to Ctrl+M server. Now the most important thing which gets asked very frequently in during the interviews as well, and this is something which you need to know as well, because between Ctrl+M EM and Ctrl+M server usually it's just the one-time setup. Okay, you just need to make sure this system and this system can interact with each other, and then you are no longer going to face any problems in terms of a port or communication. Now in case Ctrl+M EM and Ctrl+M server both are on the same subnet, in that case you are not going to have any problem in terms of ports being blocked and all. The most frequent problem which you are going to face is that is in communication between Ctrl+M server to Ctrl+M agents. Okay, this is very frequent problem. Now the reason is because all of these Ctrl+M agents are installed on different application systems. Okay, and this may be on a different data center, and this can be on a different subnets. So that's why you are going to face lots of complexity whenever you are installing a new agent and you are trying to discover that new agent in Ctrl+M server. Now the thing which you need to know is what are the ports on which these components interact with each other. So whenever Ctrl+M server wants to interact with Ctrl+M agent, it is going to be interacting on port 7006. Okay, what it means is that on Ctrl+M agent server, so let's take an example of this server where you have, let's say, some scripts running which takes care of managing web application. Now whenever you want to schedule those scripts, in that case Ctrl+M server is going to interact with Ctrl+M agent on port 7006. So on Ctrl+M agent servers there should be a process running on which is listening on port 7006. Okay, now this process gets auto created or auto started whenever you install and start Ctrl+M agent, so you don't really need to bother about this. Only thing which you need to bother about is that you have not changed the default port. If you have changed the default port, then you need to make sure the communication is going to happen between that port. Now, you need to make sure that there is a connection available or there is no firewall blocking this port 7006. So if this port is blocked, in that case Control-M server is not going to be able to communicate with Control-M agent on 7006 port. Now the other thing is that Control-M agent can also connect to Control-M server and it is going to use port 7005. Now in this case you see both can initiate the connection, okay, connection request, or you can say a request for communication transmission. So in this case Control-M server is initiating a request to connect to Control-M agent. However, let's see if Control-M agent wants, Control-M agent can also initiate a request to connect to Control-M server, and in that case Control-M server listens on a port which is called 7005. So you need to make sure port 7005 is opened from this server, which is a web application, and this server, Control-M server. Now the benefit of having Control-M server and Control-M agent communicating on two different ports are, so for example, let's say you have 1000 jobs, okay, you have around 1000 scripts running on this server, which is called web application server, and in that case Control-M server is going to request the agent to run the jobs, okay, based on the scheduling frequency. Now Control-M server is not going to have an open connection throughout, like 24/7 it is not going to have an open connection between Control-M server to web application, because from communication point of view that is not good, because your bandwidth is going to get choked, and secondly from Control-M server point of view, Control-M server is really going to get overwhelmed if it has to keep the connection open with all the agents. Because typically in a Control-M environment, you are going to install Control-M agents probably on hundreds of machines or thousands of machines in a really large organization. So in that case, Control-M server is not going to have an open connection to all of those agents all the time. Okay, because that is really going to impact the performance of Control-M server. So what happens is whenever a new job request comes or job management request comes, Control-M server is just going to send those requests to Control-M agent. And then it is just going to close the connection, okay, and then Control-M agent, it is Control-M agent's responsibility to make sure that job is launching on the scheduling time, it is running, and then whatever the response which has received on the, you know, execution of that job, that has to be submitted back to Control-M server. And that's why, let's say when the job executes successfully, it is the Control-M agent's responsibility to tell the status back to Control-M server, and that communication is going to happen on port 7005. Now let's say for some reason Control-M agent is not able to tell the result back to Control-M server. In that case, what is going to happen is that Control-M server is going to check again with Control-M agent on a specified frequency. So by default that frequency is 15 minutes. So after every 15 minutes, Control-M server is going to connect again to Control-M agent, and that communication is going to happen on port 7006. So it is like kind of double checking, okay. Let's say if Control-M agent has not sent any response in last 15 minutes, in that case Control-M server is going to connect to Control-M agent again and going to see what has been going on, okay. So that's how different Control-M components communicate with each other, and these are the important ports which you need to make sure that you are aware of, and this is something which you also need to take care of whenever you are implementing Control-M in a new environment. Again, here we discussed about ports which are very frequently used. Other than this, there are many other ports which you need to take care of. So whenever you are going to install Control-M in your production system, just make sure you have gone through the installation document and you understand the ports requirement.